Welcome to Express, the ELFI podcast, where industry leaders express their points of view on topics that affect the fund industry in Luxembourg and around the world. Today, I'm talking to Chris Stewart Sinclair, his director at Deloitte here in Luxembourg. AIFMD, Mr. Sinclair, introduces new obligations concerning reporting, concerning transparency. What will be their impact on hedge funds?
I think there's going to be impact at several different stages and several different speeds. The first impact is going to be, of course, the reflection of the hedge fund managers as to whether or not the potential goal of enhanced asset gathering is worth the effort of this disclosure, this reporting. Once that reflection is finished, then it will be obviously the phase of finding the means, the systems, the partners to make that reporting the most efficient and streamlined as possible. There are going to be other effects, I think, going beyond that. And one will be it will prepare the alternatives industry for greater levels of investor protection. And here I can easily see the parallels coming in with UCITS IV and the KID, the Key Investor Information Document, for example, which is already being used in some countries for domestic alternative products. And the other sector I think is going to be very interesting is going to be that it will demystify hedge funds to a certain extent. One of the issues in 2008 was we were not able to define clearly what was the role of the hedge fund in terms of leverage, in provoking or accelerating the financial crisis. By having this centralized reporting, by having the possibility for the regulator to see what hedge funds are doing, we will be able to actually assess, monitor, and genuinely appreciate the role the hedge funds are playing.
Do you believe that the EU passport offered by the directive will constitute an effective competitive advantage?
Competitive advantage in itself, possibly not per se. Where I think the passport obviously has huge potential and where it will be a competitive advantage is if the industry in general succeeds in creating the same sort of brand recognition around an IFM passport as it has around the UCITS passport. That UCITS passport has been one of the major successes of the EU internal market over the last 25 years. From a piece of legislation which was originally designed just to establish a level playing field, we have an internationally, a globally recognized brand, a brand that even causes a certain amount of concern on the other side of the Atlantic because of its brand recognition and because of its global nature. And if IFM can do the same thing, then the passport will certainly be a competitive advantage. In the meantime, it will certainly facilitate and make more homogeneous the distribution of alternative products throughout the European Union.
Many obligations imposed to the AIFM derive from UCITS. This should be a clear advantage for UCITS managers, shouldn't it?
In a way, yes. In a way, no. I think although some of the larger houses obviously are very active in both the alternatives area, the hedge fund area, and the traditional, more traditional long-only sectors, even within those houses, quite often the two divisions are quite separate. So you don't necessarily see that economy of scale or that synergy coming through automatically. However, there are several other things going on at the same time, which do mean that that synergy, that integration is happening de facto. One is this whole introduction of alternative UCITS, the more complex UCITS, and we know there is a very active debate going on at the moment on the future of those. And that has brought the more traditional alternative managers into the, shall we say, mainstream arena, closer to the UCITS arena. And at the same time, we do see the traditional UCITS managers using the eligible asset criteria to be able to offer products which do broaden the scope of the investment choices to investors. So I wouldn't actually say that it's going to be an advantage for the UCITS managers, but I think there are going to be some interesting synergies developing, particularly around how they can use a single management company.
The re-domiciliation of offshore funds has been discussed a lot. It seems finally that the number of effective onshore relocations is not that high, not as high as expected. How do you see the trend for the coming months?
And interestingly, I think there have been a couple of market surveys. There was one earlier this year, right at the beginning of the year, and then one that we did ourselves recently. And we found that about only 25% of the market was actually actively considering redomiciliation or had done so. Another 27% of the market was thinking this might be a possibility. 50% had absolutely no intention to do so. And I wouldn't anticipate that trend changing. I think what we're likely to see is more analysis happening of how one could combine the strengths of existing structures and the possibilities offered by potentially new vehicles, new domiciliation places for management companies. For example, leveraging all the advantages of a Cayman or a BVI with all the advantages of a Luxembourg or Dublin or any other centre which has a very, very active and sophisticated fund market.
Thank you very much.
My pleasure.